So I just arrived here at East Coast Volkswagen, which is right next to East Coast Honda. And yesterday, I was out here doing some filming, and I saw a Passat GT over here. So there's quite a few vehicles that came in. You can see there's a Jetta. It's different vehicles with their plastic still on them. A lot of Hondas over here too, because East Coast Honda's right next door and they're running out of room. I think they had like 800 new cars, something like that. It's ridiculous, but lots and lots of Hondas over here. So chances are on East Coast you'll find what you want, whether it be a Volkswagen or a Honda. So let's see if we can find, yeah, I think there it is, that GT. That's the one with the V6. So it's right here. Check out that red on the front end and that gloss black. And those wheels, holy crap. Looks like it has the LED headlights. Are those LEDs? Now, look like regular headlights. We'll find out, won't we? Have to get the keys. So it's locked up. Let's look at the back. That little tiny spoiler in black. It's pretty neat. Wow, look at there. It actually has exhaust surrounds. Or are those exhaust tips? They look like exhaust tips, yeah. Nice. It doesn't have the fake exhaust like some of them. Some of the Volkswagens. Has the blind spot monitor. So there's the stock number, 398. Let's go get the key. Walk over here, and while we're walking, we're gonna talk about going to dealerships in general. Maybe in the description you can tell me about what your experience has been, if you've ever been to this dealership or any dealership in which you showed up, and you know, just what was your experience? Was it positive? Was it negative? Oh yeah, on the way, check it out. It's a GTI. This is the Autobahn. Saw this over here too. This camera can pierce the reflection of the window. They have these stickers on it though, that kind of takes away from the look. But nice. Continuing on. So here's the East Coast Volkswagen. Check out these. I think pretty much all the Volkswagens have these. Nice frontage here. I go in a side door. Whew, feels much better in here. There's Terry, he's in his office with a customer. We're not gonna disturb him. There's the number one salesperson at the dealership. Okay, I got the key. Key was on the board, so I didn't have to go searching for it. Check out this bicycle rack. Feels much cooler in there. It's too hot. Does this thing have remote start? Doesn't look like it. Too bad. I'll go ahead and start it up, get the air conditioner going. It is a hot day, but it did feel good in there to cool off for a minute. Now I'm feeling a lot better. But setting all the, up all the camera equipment and everything, and starts to break a sweat. And when it's 100 degrees out now, it seems like it's a little bit cooler because there's a storm, thunderstorm coming. So we'll see. See what happens. All right, so let's go ahead and open the door. Move the seat back. It seems like there's always people that are really short that adjust the seat. Ooh, seats are hot.
Making a bunch of itemized deductions and you don't have like property.
Don't want to hear the radio. Oh man. Low on fuel. All right. This camera goes too quick. Please refuel. All right. Then there's this random paperclip in here. I wonder what that's doing in here. Sometimes I find random stuff. I found a diamond in the floor one time, just a few days ago. I gave it to the manager and he said it was fake, but he'll still keep an eye out for somebody's missing one. All right, let's go ahead and drive around. Drive over there anyway. That's where we're gonna do the video. I try to stay out of the way so that way I'm not in anybody's way, you know, doing my filming. And also a lot of people, they just don't really want to be on camera. They want to kind of camera shy. Seems like some people will be fine with being on camera, but they don't, you know, like their face. They could be on camera like their face. You know, if you just happen to walk by and aim the camera at them like this, maybe they'll deal with it. But they don't want to talk on camera. They don't want to talk. They want to, if they hear their voice on camera, they're like, they don't really like it. I think that's a common thing because we're not used to hearing ourselves speak. This guy behind me, what's he doing? What's he doing back there? I don't know what he's doing, but I know what I'm doing. I'm getting too close to that pole back there. That's what I'm doing. Pull up. So the sun. Okay, so here's how I align the vehicle. So I look at this. Sometimes I take my finger and go right that, or look at the pillars, the shadow on the pillars, and see which way the sun's precisely facing. And what I'll do is I'll put like the sun at a 3/4 angle of the car. Or actually the car at a 3/4 angle of the sun. So this is about right here. I'm gonna back up, and it, you know, of course it changes throughout the day to a certain point. Then I'm gonna stop and turn the wheel. So that way you can see what the wheel looks like, kind of popping out on one side. And looks pretty cool. Man, somebody's got a blue Porsche over there. Look at that. Let's go look at that Porsche. This Volkswagen will be here for another minute. I hope. I got the keys in my hand, so. Seems like there's cops. Cops and robbers going on over here. All right. I'm not mistaken, this belongs to the number one Honda salesperson, or one of the top Honda salespeople. Look at that. That is an awesome color. It's nice. Man, that's nice. What? I'm in the wrong business. If this is who I think it is, then I'm going to have to get back in selling cars, because, man, this is ridiculous right here. Maybe he'll let me do some video footage of it. I want to drive it, or at least ride in it. What do you think about that? All right, we'll slowly walk away from it. Go back to our Volkswagen. Go back to our Volkswagen. It is a GT though. It's a V6. And it's probably a quarter of the price. So, it does look good. It has those red calipers, red in the front. Says GT, and it has real exhaust tips. You can't mess with that. Can't mess with that. See, GT. Just forget about that Porsche. This is the vehicle you want right here. If you're rich and you got, and you just like totally won the lottery, this is the car you'd probably buy, isn't it? You wouldn't buy that Porsche, you'd want this one. This is only $29,000. You think you can get that Porsche for $29,000? I don't think so. You might be able to get the wheels and tires for that. So did you think of a dealership story to tell in the comments? This has a black roof. Cool. Oh, I forgot to unlock it. Pushed the unlock button a couple times. Let's push this button. There we go. Still has the plastic in the floorboard. Got some paper over there. Let's get that out. Let's see what's in the trunk. All kinds of random stuff sometimes in the trunk. So this one just has the floor mats, front tag holder. Man, it goes way in there. Look at that. Yes, it does. I bet you that Porsche doesn't have a spare tire. It'd be kind of silly if you did have to use a donut on that car. What's this paper doing in here? Okay, let's show you this awesome car. So let's have some trash in the way while we're showing it to you. I don't like that. Do not like that at all. Now that plastic in the floorboard, that's no big deal because that actually protects a little bit. So what I do with all the trash that I find in these cars, I stuff it in my trunk. And then I have to clean my trunk out all the time. See, I have some trash, put paper over here. I cleaned it out the day before yesterday, but now I have more paper and stuff. And look at how disorganized my equipment is. Holy cow. It's just lying around. This is the most important thing though, right here. That's the ticket. Oh yeah, by the way, let me know what you think about like merchandise, like something with my logo and maybe this pointer finger, because this is the star of the show, on it, you know, something like that. Or what about like a cell phone case that has the pointer on it, so it turns your cell phone case into a pointer? So if somebody gets sassy with you, you can point with your cell phone at something and get sassy back. All right. I know this video's going on kind of a long time, so I'm gonna go ahead and do this Volkswagen over here, and I'm not gonna do that Porsche over there, so don't think about that. Think about the Volkswagen. That's what you want to see, right? Okay, so I'm done with it. Let's go and put the key back, but I want to show you something while we're in there. They actually have a toy section, so you can check out cool stuff. Every time I come here, I can check it out, all the toys. And I'm tempted to buy something, but everything is branded with Volkswagen, and I don't have a Volkswagen, so it seems a little silly. But we'll check it out anyway. So right over here, you questioned whether Jody was the number one salesperson. Check it out. There's a picture of him. It's got his name, Salesman of the Month. Now let's check out the toy section. Got backpacks, toy car, mugs, cups. What is this? Rubber bands, flowers. That's a must if you have a beetle.
Is this your customer?
No, it's Mike's.
This is what you gotta have right here. Volkswagen bus bag. It's only $59. Check it out. All right, so there you have it. I've put the key back, leaving the dealership, and cooled off in there. And it seems like it's a little bit cooler outside. I don't know if I cooled off inside. Now I don't feel the heat as much right this second, but a lot of clouds out and thunderstorms. So, and I'm looking all scruffy. So surprised to have the camera on me right now. So anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. I forgot to start up my car. I'm right here, so let's go ahead and start it up. One good thing about starting it up, the air conditioner starts up. But even if I just start it up just a few seconds before I get in, it starts up the pairing procedure for my phone. And my phone takes forever, or this particular car takes forever to pair. I mean, it's like a couple minutes, literally. So if you want to get everything set up on your cell phone to play something or whatever while you're driving, before you start driving, we have to wait on it. So I wish they'd speed that up. Maybe they did. This is a 16, so maybe they did in newer models. But this particular car, slow Bluetooth pairing. Look how dirty that is. Got coffee cup. It's like 100 degrees out and I'm drinking coffee. This cat right here, no helmet, music blaring on his motorcycle. He's cool.